Brendan Gunn in the house, back within the bang on video. But ladies and gentlemen, oh my God, burning. Yes, burning Arsenal news for you guys. The first news that's coming our way. Former Tottenham boss Mauricio Pochettino directly responds to Arsenal rumors. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we know what happened. We know he went back to Argentina to meet his family, to do his whatever needed, much needed break. But he has linked that within a week, he's going to be back. He's going to be listening to offers and he's not going to take a big, huge break. We all know that. But he had a very recent interview wherein, you know, he smiles when he was asked about Arsenal's mention. He was asked about his plans here. But look, you can actually see in that interview, you can see his reactions over the face when the reporter mentions Arsenal. Very interesting. He's set to return next week and choose his next project. Out of everything he has available, managing the Gunners is a possibility for Mauricio Pochettino. But, you know, Arsenal fans are dang worried about Arsenal's recent form. One of the Twitter users actually mentioned, no win in 2 months, relegation form, owners that don't give a shit about anything but money. Unless we score 2 or 3 goals a game, can't see us winning with this shambolic defense. Announce Poch now, enough is enough. Another one said, Arsenal just announced Poch, Allegri or Ancelotti. And another one said, announce Poch, please. Splash money, get him to the job. He is the man for the defense. Both hashtag Wenger in and hashtag Lundberg out were trending on Twitter after the defeat against Brighton. Yes, one supporter posted under the name, I won't mention his name, but still, he tweeted, I always wanted Wenger to stay. He left because of plastic fans. We miss you, Wenger. Hashtag Wenger in. Another one said, Arsenal were a wonderful club under hashtag Wenger in. Be careful what you wish for. I mean, we've got some mixed reactions. Also, another one tweeted, Ole Gunnar Solskjaer won 13 straight games before he discovered he's a fraud. Lundberg just caught after 13 minutes. Hashtag Lundberg out. And another one said, guys, is it hashtag Freddy out or is it hashtag Lundberg out? I need us to be clear on it. Oh my God. Even Arsenal fans are just like not clear about their own defense. But moving on. Mesut Ozil's rant at the end of Arsenal's game was not directed at Alexander Lacazette, but it was aimed at Freddy Lundberg. Yes, that is the view of former Manchester United and Bayern Munich midfielder Owen Hargreaves. He says that you can't play that way and be critical of the coaching staff. And that's exactly what he meant. He said that I don't think it was aimed at Pierre. It was aimed at Freddy. He didn't do enough. Mesut Ozil. Everyone is blaming Mesut Ozil, but Mesut Ozil is blaming them, Freddy Lundberg for it. But I don't want to continue with whatever rants that actually happened. But moving on, Massimiliano Allegri can come to Arsenal and replace Freddy Lundberg, but he's got two bigger problems. If those are solved, probably he could make his way to Arsenal. Firstly, the Italian needs to be convinced of the club's ambition. With the side having fallen 10 points adrift of the Champions League places, while several key players are running down their contracts. Secondly, he needs to be shown that Arsenal genuinely want him to take over. Having been left disappointed with how he was overlooked when the club were looking for a replacement for Arsene Wenger. But moving on, Real Madrid are offering Luka Jovic to Arsenal as a part exchange for Aubameyang. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Luka Jovic, since he's making his a big money move from Eintracht Frankfurt, actually with Aubameyang and Lacazette out of contract next week, the Gunners may elect to cut their losses with their top scorer. Let's see if that's going to happen or not, but most probably that this is the reason why. And the problem is that these players are not actually ready to sign a new contract, so that is actually hampering everything for Arsenal, isn't it? But since everything is actually, everyone has some, the manager, the new one who's going to come in at Arsenal, has a bigger headache. You know, your bigger, big bank strikers need to be sold off, in order to stop them from leaving on a free. They need to be sold off. Yeah. And most importantly, either that or a new contract signing. That can only happen if Arsenal's actually slump gets reduced to something. So let's see. Unai Emery was not the right man. Freddy Lundberg is definitely having a nightmare. He's actually jeopardizing his club legend status right now because already Lundberg out. But actually, Arsenal fans are actually trying to be a bit more respectful, stating that it's not Lundberg's fault. But let's see. We are more delusional in more things than not. But if the new manager comes in and if we start losing in the initial problems, and the problem could rise up to the general transfer window, where we should get, that is what my opinion is, get some right fullbacks, the correct central defenders, and get rid of out of those problematic defenders. Until unless that is happening, I don't think so any manager would want to dip his fingers in the mess that we are in right now. So these were the news of the day. I hope you enjoyed whatever came your way. All the views and news and everything about Arsenal comes on this platform every single day. So make sure you subscribe and be a part of this community. I will see you in my next video. Until then, cheers.